my creatives and welcome to another video. So today I'm here to share the file folder mail I made for Rickmore. A couple videos ago I created an art piece for her and this mail is bicolor inspired by that art piece, and you will see the art piece in a little bit. I am going to create a file folder mail with these two 12 by 12 sheets of pattern paper I bought at Action. So there was the art piece. If you want to see that video, you can just head over to my channel. I will try to remember to put it in the description box. So first of all, I'm going to score this paper in half, so 6 inches. And then I am going to cut it at 9 and a little bit inches, so my art piece would fit in. So it's custom made for my art piece. And now I'm using my envelope punch board to create tabs like a file folder. So this was the first time that I did this, and it wasn't perfect, but that's no biggie. So I just measured the tabs to be 2 inches with the envelope punch board, and now I'm going to cut off the pieces under the notches. But as you can see, I didn't do a completely good job at it, but that's okay. It's the first time that I made a mail like this, so that's no biggie. So I'm also going to do that on the other side, and that was a bit too long, so I'm going to cut that also a little bit extra with my scissors. So I probably should have done this with my scissors anyway. But here's the file folder that I made for this mail. So now I'm going to create a pocket for this art piece, and I'm going to use that piece with a flower on it, and I'm just going to measure out how big I want my pocket to be. So I believe it's about 5 inches or 5.5 inches. I always put on 1/2 inch on both sides, so in this case the bottom and the side, to make score lines for my gluing strips. So, and I measured 1 inch from the side to get the diagonal, if that made any sense. So now I'm just making my pocket, and I'm going to cut off the excess pieces of the glue strips to adhere it to my file folder mail. So if I sound a bit out of breath or anything, it's because I'm recovering from a respiratory infection. Don't worry, I don't have COVID. I got myself tested. It's just a regular one. But if I sound a little bit out of breath, that is why, because I'm still recovering from that. That's why I didn't post these videos back to back, because I couldn't breathe properly a couple of days ago. So that is why I'm posting this right now, and you saw the Pen Pal Journal video in between these videos. So now I'm going to create the other pocket. I make a square, and I'm going to score 1/2 inch on two sides to make a triangle pocket. And I'm going to measure, it's 1/2 inch from the gluing flap and 1 inch from the whole square. And I'm going to cut that in a triangle shape. But I use these marks to make sure that both sides will be equally cornered. I'm just going to do the same as I did on the other side. So I'm also going to stick this pocket down, and I use some binder clips to keep it down because I have a glue that is very wet. I don't particularly like this glue, but I'm going to use it up, of course. I don't want to throw it away because that would be wasteful. So I'm just going to add some binder clips to keep it into place, and now my file folder has two pockets. So in this one pocket there will be my art piece for Rickmore. And now I will create a little envelope, a 3x4 envelope, and I use my envelope punch board for that. And for a 3x4 envelope you need a 6x6 piece of paper. And I absolutely love my envelope punch board. I think I use it in almost every project, so I'm very, very happy to have this. So I just create the envelope with some scrap paper from the paper where the flowers are from, and I think it just gives an extra little interest up there with another little pocket. So this is basically the base of my whole mail. And now it is time to decorate it. So I fit in my art piece to see if it fits, and it fits perfectly. So now I'm going off to decorate my my mail. So I'm starting with the front cover, and the color scheme that I picked is orange and blue. So I went through my stash and I found all kinds of orange and blue types of embellishments. So most of these embellishments were sent to me by you guys, or pen pals, or random things I had laying around. So I can't give you all the details on what is, because it's just a mishmash, and I really encourage you to do so, to just look in your stash and maybe make a mail by color. Pick two or three colors you like and grab some embellishments, because that's also what I do before I start making a mail. I grab embellishments that would fit the color scheme, and that will make it very, very easy to make a mail with just random bits and pieces you have laying around. So this is kind of what I'm going for. So I have this big doily in my stash, and I have it since forever. I bought it at HEMA, and usually my projects aren't this big, so these big doilies don't get really used. So I remembered that I had these, and I thought this was the perfect project to use this very, very big doily on. And I'm just going to stick that down with some double-sided tape. And I'm going to stick the edges down with a bit of tape runner so it doesn't crumple up in the mail. So now I'm going to layer up my pieces, and I like to rearrange things back again when I am working to figure out if this is what I want, and then I will start with the bigger pieces and lay the smaller pieces around them. So this is a pencil I got from Heba, I believe, from my little journal. I think it's the Studio Calico pencil. And these butterflies are die cuts I received in Happy Mail from, I don't know who sent me those, but I know they were in my PO box for sure. So I'm just going to glue these things down, and then my front cover will be almost finished, because of course I have to add the name of the recipient on there. Nothing is complete without a doodly border, of course. So I'm doing a doodly border. I first did it on that small piece, and I'm adding some tiny word stickers because I just thought of it and that it would look fun. And this one says, I just want to make nice things. So I thought it was perfect for my art piece. Of course, I'm also going to do a doodly border around that. And now I'm looking for some more words for on the front cover. I can't read what they are saying right now, but you will see that in the still shots at the end of this video. Of course, I'm not done with doodly border, and I'm going to outline all the tiny word stickers. So if you wonder what I used and the things that I can find online, there's always a list of supplies down below in the description box. And if I can find it online, there are links. If I can't, then there are not. But there's always a list of supplies in the description box. Beware that some of them are affiliate links and some of them are not. But just so you know. So now I'm going to decorate the inside a little bit, and I wanted to change up the way that the envelope was closing. Usually I use a bit of washi tape, but I thought it would be fun to add a die cut on there and slip the envelope flap under there as a closure, so it would stay there. And then I found this butterfly, and I thought, perfect for on the front cover. So this is usually how I work. It's by feeling, and then I find something and I think, oh, that is what would look great on the front cover. And as you can see, I also decided to do a doodly border all around the file folder. So the alphabet stickers that I used for Rigmor, her name, are from Flow magazine. I think they were from an issue that is pretty old. I'm not quite sure. But I know for sure that I cannot find those online for you to purchase. But I thought they would give some freshness to the spread, and I like the color scheme and a bit of playfulness. So I added my sticker on the back, and now I'm going to add some enamel dots or some self-adhesive pearls. So I find these orange enamel shapes. And these have been in my stash for so long, because orange is not really my color or preferred color I work with. So I thought it was perfect to use them now on the front cover. And I always have with enamel dots that they give such a finishing look onto your piece. I don't know what it is. I love it. And I love to add them in groups of three. So now I'm also going to add some tiny words to the file folder tabs. And I'm also going to outline those with a doodly border. So back to the inside, it has my die cut has dried, so now I can take off the flap. And I found this postage stamp in the color scheme that matched, so I also added that because it's a snail mail and I love to add postage stamps to snail mail. Now I'm going to stick down this banner and I find these stickers and I remember that I received those stickers from Stephanie. I don't know who sent me these mixed media butterflies, but these were perfect for this project and I just stick them down because I also made a butterfly art piece, so I thought it would fit the mail. So I really had fun with just playing around with the things that I have in my stash and just looking around, going through my little baskets. I have my baskets color coordinated in an Alex drawer, so I can just take out one of the baskets of color that I need and I go through them and they are beside me on my crafting desk, but I usually take out pieces before I start just to make it a bit more easy on myself. I already have some supplies ready that I know that will fit and it will not feel overwhelming, because I can understand that this would feel overwhelming if you have a lot of stuff and a lot of colors. It can feel overwhelming to take all of your color coordinated boxes out. So now I'm going to take this paper set, and this is from Organized Finds, and that is an Etsy shop. And I will leave a link to her Etsy shop down below. She has beautiful letter writing sets, and the beauty of it is she also has digitals. So if you don't want to pay the shipping, you can buy a digital from her, which is really, really cool. So I will also leave that link down below in the description box. Now I just took a Stabilo orange marker to write down "Read Me" and do a faux stitching border on the envelope to give it a little bit of extra. And of course I have to add some washi samples because I know Rick Moore loves washi samples from me. So that is what I added for her. Then I also added these tags, and I bought these at Action a very long time ago, so I don't think they have them anymore. And I know Rick Moore is a card maker, so I thought maybe she could use some of these for her cards or, yeah, I don't know, her own crafting. And I'm going through this box and add some extra little die cuts that I thought would fit the mail. So usually I coordinate my goodies as well with the mail. So now I'm going to add two extra pieces of letter writing paper, because I got a sample pack from Organized Finds with one of each, which you will not get. You will get five of each, I believe. But I knew I wanted to write a little bit more than just one page letter, so that is why I created this letter writing paper for my own with just two of the washies, and I'm going to add that as well into the envelope. And there was also a sealing sticker with it, but of course I didn't stick it on there yet because I am going to write my letter. So this is the envelope and I already started the decorating. You can see that in the previous video. I used my leftover paints for the envelope, and now I'm going to add some extra little die cut pieces on there to tie the paper mail and the art piece together into the envelope. And I always like that to match an envelope with what I am making at the moment. So that is what I did here. And of course I had to do also a doodly border on the mail. I'm going to add some extra washi tape just for a little bit of extra. I tried to fit down these papers, but it covered up too much of the painting and I didn't like it. So I thought just a strip of washi tape in the blue and orange color would be perfect. And I think that will be my envelope. Will it? I can't remember. yeah, I think so. I will write down my address on the back and Rick Moore her name on the front. In the end, I used the same Stabilo marker to write down her full name and then her address in a regular black pen. But that is what I did for the envelope, and here's my own address. So that was my file folder mail. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it was a bit helpful, my voiceover. Thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video, I would love it if you'd give me a thumbs up. I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you all so much for watching and hope to see you all next time. Bye!